to the Father. Let us learn from him and celebrate his love. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
And welcome to Sacred Heart Church. Today we celebrate Pentecost Sunday. As we celebrate this morning, let us pray for the people of this parish. Let us stand to begin our celebration. Let us greet one another from our places. And our entrance hymn for you to hear will be 453 Send Us Your Spirit.
We received God's Spirit at baptism, and we were consecrated temples through our baptism, temples of the Holy Spirit. We recall our baptism, give thanks to God for it, and commit ourselves to live that baptism for God's glory and the good of our sisters and brothers. Lord our God, in your mercy, be present to your people's prayers. And for us recall the wondrous work of our creation, and the still greater work of our redemption, graciously bless this water. For you created water to make the fields fruitful, and to refresh and cleanse our lives. You also made water the instrument of your mercy, for through water you freed your people from slavery, and quenched their thirst in the desert. Through water the prophets proclaimed the new covenant, you were to enter upon the human race. And last of all, through water, which Christ made holy in the Jordan, you have renewed our corrupted nature in the bath of regeneration. Therefore, may this water be for us a memorial of the baptism we have received, and grant that we may share the gladness of our brothers and sisters, who at Easter have received their baptism, through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
our sins, and through the celebration of this Eucharist, make us worthy to share at the table of his kingdom. O God, who by the mystery of today's great feast sanctify your whole church in every people and nation, pour out, we pray, the gifts of the Holy Spirit across the face of the earth. And with the divine grace that was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, fill now once more the hearts of your believers. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
When the time for Pentecost was fulfilled, they were all in one place together. And suddenly there came from the sky a noise like a strong driving wind, and it filled the entire house in which they were. Then there appeared to them tongues as of fire, which parted and came to rest on each one of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in different tongues as the Spirit enabled them to proclaim. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven staying in Jerusalem. At this sound, they gathered in a large crowd, but they were confused because each one heard them speaking in his own language. They were astounded, and in amazement, they asked, "Are not all these people who are speaking Galileans? Then how does each of us hear them in his native language? We are Parthians, Medes, Elamites, inhabitants of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt, and the districts of Libya near Cyrene, as well as travelers from Rome, both Jews and converts to Judaism, Cretans and Arabs, yet we hear them speaking in our own tongues of the mighty acts of God." The word of the Lord. Reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, no one can say Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit. There are different kinds of spiritual gifts, but the same Spirit. There are different forms of service, but the same Lord. There are different workings, but the same God who produces all of them in everyone. To each individual, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for some benefit. As a body is one, though it has many parts, and all the parts of the body, though many, are one body, so also Christ. For in one Spirit, we were all baptized into one body, whether Jews or Greeks, slaves or free persons, and we were all given to drink of one Spirit. The word of the Lord.
reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, we find ourselves at the end of the Easter season. And you know, it's a to say the least, an interesting time. We are in a sort of situation that none of us has ever experienced before. And this is worldwide. And in the midst of this, we find ourselves again as a country descending into violence. It's frustrating, it's unsettling. It can be scary. There's a whole set of emotions. And I think really we're here today because the Lord wants us to be part of the answer. You know, it's fascinating. I've been reflecting recently about how the nature of things seems to be to communicate. And that's what people do. And amazingly, we can convince each other of all kinds of things. As a matter of fact, every word we speak is a proposition trying to convince somebody of something. Every utterance, in a sense, is an attempt to convey a truth that we want others to understand. And further, to get people to do what we would like them to do. That's at the human level, but we can even look, at nature. Things are so created as to let each other know what's going on. Flowers give off smells so that the bees come. And on down the line. Even in the basic chemical structure of things, molecules organize themselves. And it seems that the whole project of existence is to communicate, to be understood and to convince. And what more, how much more dramatic is that on Pentecost, when we have people speaking in different tongues? And it's a wonderful affirmation of difference. God speaks to us, and invites us to speak to others in a way that they can understand, that makes sense to them, that is consonant with their experience and identity. That was what got people, got their attention. It wasn't that, okay, we're going to speak Greek now because that's the language of the empire. We've all got to do that. It was that spirit was helping God's message be understood to each in a way that he or she could understand. The power of communication. And yet, we see in human history how that communication can be hijacked. How communication can turn into untruth and lies. And we've seen the effects of that through the ages. We even see we're living in a time when this virus is ruling our lives. And how does it work? Well, it tricks the host cell. It lies to the host cell and then begins its destruction. That's the power of communicating with the wrong intention. It happens in nature, in humans, we do it ourselves. Now, we may remember from our catechism classes, CCD, or some other study, that the Holy Spirit has seven gifts. And so I wrote them down just so I remember them all. Wisdom, understanding, counsel, courage, knowledge, reverence of the Lord, and wonder in God's presence. Well, if we look around, we don't see a whole lot of that. At least not what's dominating our news cycle. We're living again in an extremely tragic time. When the problems we thought we solved 40, 50 years ago, it's become very clear they're not solved. And at the same time, we run into the disciples who are locked in the upper room, paralyzed with fear. They do not know what to do. Now, many of us have been locked in our houses, or at least have had our movement somewhat restricted. There is fear. People are afraid they might get sick, with good reason. And now we find ourselves faced with violence, faced with the truth that our society isn't as just or equal as we might have hoped it would be. And here's where Pentecost comes to us. I really think, in trying to reflect on this, and it's just so sad and frustrating, and that's my perspective. I don't have to live in fear that many other people do. That my actions will be misinterpreted. Or that I receive different treatment, preferential treatment, or unpreferential treatment. But here's where the Holy Spirit comes to us. It's much more than a nice story and a pretty picture on a Hallmark card or a work of art with people sort of gazing in wonder and nice little flames come from their head. This Pentecost is for us to become the gifts of the Spirit for the healing of our world. And that happens in many ways. Each, just like when people heard in the gospel, or not in the gospel, the first reading, when people understood what was being said in their own language, each of us in our own way, we try to speak and be peace and healing for all. I think first that means spending some time reflecting on where people hurt, trying to understand what people's experiences, especially those different from mine, rather than approach the situation, which is so easy, and usually how we humans do things, we have our minds made up and have the solution already, or at least we think we understand the situation. I don't know that we understand the situation. Reacting is easy. Being sent by the Holy Spirit is quite another thing. And I think on this Pentecost, we're called to reflect on ourselves, on our histories of people, on who we are as a church, and experience deeply that longing for God, and letting ourselves be overwhelmed by the Spirit that comes to us, maybe when we least expect, perhaps in the way we least expect, and takes us from where we are comfortable, or where we have locked ourselves in fear, and is a recreation and a freedom. That's actually how the gospel ends. He sends the disciples out to free others. And it's so clear that so many of us are in chains and bondage to all kinds of things. And if anything, the Spirit comes upon us to make others free. We pray for that grace to understand the Holy Spirit, to let the Holy Spirit come into our lives, to put aside what we have already convinced ourselves of, and to be freedom for others, that we may be God's healing for all. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, who became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Trusting in God's love and mercy, and acknowledging our great need and incompleteness, we lift our prayers to the Lord.
We're all entrusted with the Word of God. For preachers, presbyters, pastors, and parents, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For firefighters, postal workers, garbage collectors, for all who work to keep this complex world going, let us pray to the Lord. For print and broadcast journalists, for all who provide truthful information in the media, let us pray to the Lord. For the newly baptized and confirmed, for all members of this assembly, let us pray to the Lord. And for the sick of our parish, especially those listed in our bulletin, let us pray to the Lord. And for our deceased, especially Ibidi Alfaro, let us pray to the Lord.
Loving God, we come before you. Make us instruments of your love. Grant us what we ask for, and what you ask of us, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that as promised by your Son, the Holy Spirit may reveal to us more abundantly the hidden mystery of this sacrifice and graciously lead us into all truth, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, and Eternal God. For bringing your Paschal mystery to completion, you bestowed the Holy Spirit today on those you made your adopted children, by uniting them to your only begotten Son. This same Spirit, as the Church came to birth, opened to all peoples the knowledge of God, and brought together the many languages of the earth in profession of the one faith. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope and Barry, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, especially Ovidio Alfaro and Mike Thompson, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, your spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life. In the name of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.